Everything gone that you had designed strategically and specifically and descriptively for me to begin to encounter is your enemy that would intensify your warfare, that would increase the fire in your prayer life, that would get you down on bended knees, get you stretching out, not the regular wheel but the perfect wheels. It's your enemy that would cause you to line up, walk upright and circumspect. It's your enemy that would get you down on your knees if you never bowed before him in spirit and in truth, in the beauty of holiness before. You would begin to do it right now.
Yes, Jesus.
Because of your enemy, Saul didn't destroy David. David recognized something that most of us never have the ability to insightfully pick a war in our life. You didn't realize that Saul was really a blessing. Because of Saul, he has a more unified, connected link relationally with the Holy Spirit. Because of Saul, he's beginning now to see God, the power, the awesomeness of who God is and what God divinely begins to represent. And if he doesn't see him manifested in the flesh, he sees him divinely as an agency that is released as a virus into the atmosphere to do battle and warfare on his behalf. David, he eagerly begins to let you know that he doesn't fight his own battles. He says that it is God that giveth me the victory. He wants you to know, he says, blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. He helps you to know it is not by reason of my own iniquity, my own transgression, or my own sins, but it's because he had put